And thousands of Maryland families are facing foreclosure. Among them, a Howard County family that has owned their farm for more than 175 years. In their struggle to keep it, they took out a loan. But instead of helping, they say that deal only made things worse. I-Team reporter Barry Sims investigates.
With the turn of a key, Ruth Hearn unlocks a gate and gives us a glimpse of her life here at Wincopia Farms in Laurel. No chickens or cattle roam this sprawling 125 acres. Flowers are the cash crop.
We have a crop of pansies, a few that we're getting ready to ship out to the market.
But soon this greenhouse may give way to development. The property was auctioned in a foreclosure sale. We spoke with owner Ruth Hearn hours after it happened.
Kind of nice being back in here and just for a short time to enjoy what I have for the last 60 years.
Hearn has an obvious emotional attachment to the farm, advertised as a prime location for 240 homes.
It has been very difficult to find the right loan for us.
In financial trouble and trying to keep their business moving forward, the Hearns took out a loan in 2002. It was no ordinary financing package. Ruth's daughter, Emily, says a broker helped them get it.
Well, we went to a bank, and evidently the bank, the loan officer, had a business himself that he was that he did private funding. So he took us to another private funder.
The private funds come from D. Trent Gourley. He runs G&G LLC from his home in McLean, Virginia, just outside Washington. The Hearns wanted to pay off old debts and needed operating capital. They also wanted 5 years to repay. But the $4.5 million loan they received had to be paid back in 1 year, and all the interest had to be paid up front, most of it characterized as a contribution to G&G.
We were told that we had to invest $360,000 into his business.
What did you and your family think?
Well, we were faced with the fact that we didn't have another loan and that we were going to be in default if we did not go forward with the loan.
So you just did?
So we had to do it.
When they weren't able to pay it back in 1 year, interest rose to more than 16%. By foreclosure, it was 22%.
Hi, Mr. Gourley.
The I-Team found D. Trent Gourley inside the garage of his home. Okay. He would not comment. Off camera, the company's attorney called G&G a, quote, relationship lender, a company that works with borrowers. He said G&G advised the Hearns to section off and sell lots to pay back the loan. This 2007 appraisal acquired by the Hearns lists their land value at more than $31 million, $60 million if developed into a residential subdivision. The Hearns say they tried to sell it for $100 million, but there weren't any takers. At the foreclosure auction, the property sold for far less, $12.5 million. The purchaser, Gourley's company, G&G.
So what do you do now?
I don't know how you would start over.
According to G&G, the Hearns, over several years, modified and extended the agreement. Then they defaulted on the loan. According to court records, they owe nearly $12 million. Now they're in a court battle fighting to keep their land. They aren't the only ones.
It has destroyed my community. It has destroyed my church. It has destroyed my school. And our people do not have a place to come to worship.
We discovered members of a Hindu temple.
All rise, please.
Took their case to the New Hampshire Supreme Court. They battled over 100 acres of land worth about $3 million. The property sold at foreclosure to a subsidiary of G&G. Court records show an internet broker guided the temple's leader to G&G for the loan.
Imagine they were charging us on $1.7 million, 23% interest.
The temple won a portion of its appeal. A lower court will hear the case on whether G&G exerted reasonable efforts to obtain a fair price at the foreclosure sale. And trouble for G&G in Virginia. That state claims the company was soliciting investors across the country to participate in a mortgage pool, but was actually selling unregistered securities. And D. Trent Gourley was not licensed to sell them. The company has agreed to liquidate, but says it's done nothing wrong. And the issues with the state of Virginia have nothing to do with the acquisition of the Hearns farm.
Well, I know that the Lord has a plan for us, and I just hope that I'm able to do what is best for the family from here on out.
But court rulings have not been in the Hearns' favor. At a recent hearing, a judge called foreclosure a process that's tragic and unforgiving, but he said he found nothing illegal. The Hearns are still holding out hope that somehow they can keep the farm that's been in their family for more than 175 years. For the 11 News I-Team, I'm Barry Sims.